Who are you?
Silkwing, the flower elf.
Flower elf? Oh.
I live in a beautiful garden within the Wind King. It blew me high in the sky. It blew me so high up I was above the trees in the mountains. When I looked down, everything looked so small. Then the wind stopped and I came down here and I don't know where I am. Where's my home in the beautiful garden? And where am I? I'm lost.
I want to help you, Silkwing. But I'm lost too. I don't have any idea where I am. I come from a small village. Then a wolf tried to catch me and I ran and ran. And this is where I wound up.
A wolf? I'm scared.
Nothing to worry about around here. Are you really and truly a flower elf? Well, I'm Aesop. How do you do? We have the same problem. We're both lost children. You want to be back in your garden again, and I want to go back to my mother in the village that I came from. So come on.
But where?
The wind carried you here. There's a breeze blowing from the south, so it must have brought you here from the south, and therefore, that's where your garden must be, right?
Uh-huh. It might be.
When I was little, my mother used to tell me fairy stories, and many of them were about elves who live in gardens, and the elves had magical powers.
They did?
If we can find the garden where you're from, I believe I'll be able to find my home and my mother. So come on, Silkwing, let's go.
Now we won't be lonely, will we, Aesop?
As my mother always said to me, two heads are better than one, so we'll be able to give each other some help.
You're smart, Aesop. I've never met anyone so clever.
You're embarrassing me. Me smart? I don't know how to swim.
Oh.
Wait a minute. The water's not deep.
Here.
Oh, thanks.
Aesop, are you all right?
Wet, but I couldn't be better. Oh. Choo. Sorry. Choo. Another mouse that talks?
Hello, Mr. Mouse.
Greetings. I've gotten myself so dusty walking in the country.
How could he be so fussy?
By the way, while you were walking around, did you meet a country mouse by the name of Skitter? Skitter just happens to be a very good friend of mine.
He's a country mouse?
That's right. He's not a city mouse like I am. Frankly, I think the country's for the birds. How can anybody tell where they're going without any streets? You can live anywhere, but you're living nowhere.
Mr. Mouse, are you trying to tell us you're lost?
Well, yes, I guess I am.
Today should be a holiday called Everybody Lost Day.
I did meet a mouse who told me that Skitter was his name. I'll show you where.
Ah, thank you. How can I be lost with a flower elf on my arm? Lead the way.
Onward, then.
Hi, Country Mouse.
Huh? City Mouse, thanks for coming. I've been looking forward to your visit.
He was lost, so we had to show him the way.
Ah, and who are you?
Aesop's my name. How do you do?
And this lovely creature is Silkwing, a flower elf.
Hello, Mouse.
You have such a nice place here. May we visit?
Ah, yes, of course. What a pleasure to have you. The more the merrier, I always say. It's a country custom that when you live in the country, you must always welcome visitors. Come on in. It gets so lonely here sometimes that I always keep food on the table in case somebody drops by. So even though I didn't expect visitors, I'm ready for visitors. Come on, come on, come on in.
What a dump.
It may be simple country fare, but it's delicious and healthy. I've been saving this food for years. I remember burying this nut 5 years ago under the garden wall, then digging it up last summer, so enjoy.
Is this the best food you've got?
Oh, yes, my city friend, and there's plenty more where this comes from. Go ahead, eat all you want, and when it's gone, I'll dig up some more.
This food may be healthy, but how can you eat it when it's so horrible?
Huh? How can it be horrible?
You poor country mouse living in the country. You may think you live a beautiful life here, but to a sophisticated and cosmopolitan mouse like me, it's miserable. That food is nothing but garbage and tastes like it. I've got it. Come to the city with me, and I'll show you what life should really be like, and you'll have some real food. Okay, come on. I throw here. Here we are. This is my home. There.
Oh, it looks like a palace big enough for a king.
Shh, don't talk so loud.
Huh?
Okay, come on in. Here we are. Come on in here. Huh? Oh. Sit down, and you may have all you want to eat.
Oh.
To me, this isn't anything special. It's what I eat every day.
Mm. Good.
Delicious.
Mm. Yummy, yummy, says my tummy.
It gives me great pleasure, Master, to announce your dinner is served.
Beat it. Come on, quick. Hurry up and hide.
Why hide?
Come on, this way. Over here. Hurry, hurry.
And fish again. I'm tired of the same thing every night. I want something different. I'm fed up with that stuff.
You are?
What's for dessert tonight?
Pumpkin souffle, your favorite.
Just because it's my favorite, I don't want it every night. Now it's my unfavorite. Hey, I detect the delicious aroma of mouse. Mm-hmm. How about a nice dish of barbecued mouse sprinkled with paprika and garlic?
Barbecued mouse with garlic? It sounds delicious.
I'll wait for it.
No problem, Mr. Simba.
They've gone. Let's all eat. Come on, hurry up. Eat anything you want and enjoy. Sit down. Just dig right in and stuff yourselves. You see, this is the kind of feast I enjoy every night here in the city. Be my guests, friends. But you'd better eat fast.
Not one. Catch it. I'll have it for dinner, too.
Run.
I want that one roasted. That's it. Come on. Clumsy. Mouse. That's it. Go on. Catch that mouse. I'm going to catch that mouse if you don't. Come on. We're going to throw you guys out of the cat union unless you catch that mouse. Come on. Go.
Quick, let's get out of here. Relax, friends. We're safe now.
I never get scared that much in the country.
I never got a chance to eat any of that food back there.
Do you live with those cats?
Mm-hmm. I live there like one of the family. I just have to keep out of their sight when they're hungry. A certain amount of risk is worth the reward.
If that city life, it's too scary for me.
Me too.
Instead of living in a big fancy house in the city and eating all that rich food, I'd rather live in a simple country house and feast on seeds and nuts.
Well, everybody to his own taste.
I'm going back where it's safer. Thanks for your hospitality.
Come again anytime and bring all your country mouse friends. I'll give them the run of the house. Here, take this.
The mousey bag to take home? Thanks.
Let's go, Silkwing.
All right.
Goodbye, Mr. Mouse.
Goodbye, my friends. So long. Come on back anytime.
I'm hungry. Let's eat.
Here we are.
Thank you, Skitter.
And here, city food in the country.
He gave us so much.
Ah, delicious.
Huh? Just like Mama's.
Huh?
My mother used to bake me a pie that tasted this way, only without all the catnip.
Oh.
Your mother used to bake pies for you?
Mother, I wonder what she's doing now.
I can see you miss her. I hope you find her.
She might be at her window looking at that same moon.
Aesop.
No one's waiting for me to come back home. So I hope you won't mind if I travel with you for at least part of the way. And you're liable to find me very helpful.
Helpful?
Besides, when we find your mother, I want her to cook for me. And I'd love to see your garden.
The three of us have gone this far already. We would love you to come the rest of the way.
Now we're a team, aren't we, Silkwing? As someone said, nine for one and one for all. But I'm very bad in arithmetic.
Nine?
Aesop, I've got to confess to you, I don't have any family of my own. So from now on, I'm going to make believe that you're my family.
I'm very flattered. And you're more than welcome to be part of my family.
Oh, I'm so happy I could sing.
The world looks so big. Do you think we'll ever find our way home again?
Tomorrow morning, we'll be on our way.
We're starting on our way to wherever it may be. With good friends together, we will travel safe and travel free. Three for one and one for all. What a lucky me. We're a team of family looking for a home. Hi!
On our way now, ho, ho, ho. On our way we go, go, go. Gonna travel far and wide. With our friends we're side by side. Starting here today.
Listen.
Slowpoke, my tortoise is a slowpoke. I can beat you anytime. Slowpoke.
Oh, I'm not a slowpoke. It just takes me more time.
If tortoises aren't the slowest pokes in the whole world, then who are?
A dumb question. Don't bother me, Hare.
You're nothing but a slowpoke.
You're making me very angry.
Get angry. I'll just run away and you'll never be able to catch me, slowpoke.
That's what you think. You're making me angrier.
And you're making me laugh even more.
Stop it.
Oh, don't fight.
Why can't you two be friendly?
This harebrained hare keeps calling me a slowpoke, and I'm not.
I call you a slowpoke because you are.
It's not true. If it came to a race, you could never beat me.
Who ever heard of a tortoise beating a hare?
Be careful, tortoise. You better not claim you can beat a hare in a race unless you can prove it.
You'll be called a liar if you say you can do something and you can't.
I'll prove it. I'll race that harebrained hare.
Now you're being stubborn, tortoise. Everybody knows there's no way a tortoise can win a race against a hare.
I can, and I will, and I challenge that hare to a race.
All right. So you want to prove yourself to him. Will you agree to a race?
Sure, and I'll agree to win.
Get ready, then. And the first one to reach the top of that hill will be the winner.
That'll be easy.
Easy for me.
Here you are. This is the starting line.
Fall down and you won't get up.
When I win, I hope you won't be a sore loser.
Ready, get set, go! He's almost flying.
Oh.